Hey guys, so as I said last week, relative to the preparation for Ramadan, and then obviously the intention and goal, be it to either gain, which like I said, there is the opportunity and the potential to increase in muscle mass even when fasting. For those Muslims who are obviously going to be fasting from sunrise to sunset, and then also those non-Muslims who intend to partake in some form of intermittent fasting, there is, as per the literature, the opportunity to increase in muscle mass. But for those who generally going through the month of Ramadan just simply intend to maintain some form of fitness, number one, or more specifically as per my prior discussion, just to maintain the muscle mass, as so, or rather a better way to put it, not lose any muscle mass, then there are various factors which come into play when we're looking at preparation. But more specifically, as I've said previously, the one thing that you have to maintain is not having a caloric deficit. Now, it's difficult to comprehend, as I've also previously mentioned, but if you construct or plan correctly, then you should be looking at, for like I said, approximately an 85 to 90 kilogram individual, you should be looking to consume approximately between 3,000 and 3,500 calories. So as an example, I've constructed exactly what I will be consuming on a day-to-day basis, and just as a guideline, I want to mention firstly what we're going to be looking at. So the first thing is, one, to consume approximately 1,000 calories prior to commencement of fasting, so approximately 1,500, and after breaking fast, which in Cape Town, South Africa, is approximately 6 p.m., then you should be consuming approximately 2,000 calories, just above 2,000 bucks. In my example and construction of my macros as well as caloric intake, it is approximately 2,066 calories specifically. So, what would your diet look like if consuming your calories prior to commencement of fast? Well, the moment you stand up, drink a glass of water, right? So as to get enough water in for the day ahead. Drink your glass of water to start with. Then consume approximately 5 dates. Obviously, not all at once. If you want to and it works for you, that's also okay. But obviously, just think about your digestive purposes and digestive enzymes. So consume approximately 5 dates. So the diet that I won't be making available, either by direct messaging or getting a hold of me via email, I've made use of medjool dates, and they're quite high in calories as well as carbohydrate makeup. But this is okay, because I'll later on be speaking about glycogen stores, energy stores for that matter, to simplify. And this is okay relative to a slow release form of carbohydrate, the complexity of it for that matter. Then thereafter, you would want to have a smoothie, and my smoothie of choice is the equivalent of Kauai's, what do you call this, peanut butter bomb. So what is it comprised of? One, a medium-sized banana. Two, you're going to have 1 tablespoon of peanut butter. Three, 1 teaspoon of coffee. Four, you're going to have approximately 100 milliliters of water. Five, you're going to have approximately 100 milliliters of low-fat milk. And six, and more specifically, or most specifically and importantly, 1.5 scoops of whey protein. Now, for those who have asked or discussed this with me, if you have access or you have stores of casein protein, that would be ideal. But we all know that casein is really expensive, and for this purposes, whey protein would be a good replacement. So that is your smoothie. You mix it up with a smoothie maker and you consume that. And now this, obviously to consume as much calories so early in the morning is kind of difficult. So you want to stand up approximately an hour and a half prior to commencement of fast. And this is a bit easier in Cape Town because commencement of fast starts approximately 6 a.m. if I'm correct. So it's not too difficult, especially for those who are preparing for work, etc. Then you've now consumed your 5 dates, your glass of water, your smoothie. You want to relax a bit, and then approximately half an hour later, you're going to have your solid meal in the form of between 4 and 6 eggs. So if you're having 4 eggs, three of which would be only egg whites, and then the fourth would be your whole egg, including the egg yolk. If you're having 6 eggs, then you're having 5 egg whites and 1 whole egg, including the egg yolk. Together with that, you're going to have your 4 slices of whole wheat bread. Seed loaf, more specifically, would be better. Remember, your roughage, soluble or insoluble, the one's going to contribute towards digestion, the other's going to contribute towards motility of your fecal mass. So benefits are great. Then that's basically what you're going to consume in terms of your calories. Remember, water intake, although not contributing to your calories, is still going to contribute largely towards many other aspects of your health, and therefore I would advise it. So like I said in the beginning of the, just when you're standing up, consume your one glass, but also as you're going through your breakfast, and scientifically let's just say, and ingestion or consuming of your other calories, then take in as much water as possible. I would suggest between 2 and 4 glasses of water. Then you're starting your day of fast, you're going through your day of fast. Now it reaches breaking of fast, which once again in Cape Town, South Africa, you are going to break fast approximately 6 p.m. And that's not a very long day given the fact that it is winter here. So now when breaking your fast at 6 p.m., this is basically how you're breaking your fast in terms of your calorie intake is going to look. So the first thing, you're going to consume approximately 3 medjool dates. If you've got other forms of dates or other, let's call it other types of dates, that is also okay. I've just worked on that for this construction of a diet, as well as the description of the amount of calories, protein makeup, carbohydrate makeup, as well as the fat makeup. So you can check all of this either online, or if you have a specific calorie calculator and macro calculator, that's also okay. All of which can be specific to your preference of food intake. So like I said, 3 medjool dates, 1 glass of water, and then thereafter you will have meal one. What does meal one construct, or what is meal one made up of? So meal one is made up of the following: 100 grams of basmati rice, 1 cup of veggies. You can have preferably greens, so your broccoli, your green beans, and the like. Then also 150 grams of a protein source. So if you're having, you know, chicken breast, or you're going to have your steak or mutton for that matter, or fish, whatever your preference is, don't worry too much about your keto approach for that matter. As long as you're getting in your protein, 150 grams of protein for meal one, that's after breaking off fast, then you are on track towards your calorie intake. Then basically, the question of, can you have some fries, some horses, pies, dulcis and the like? Yes, you can. It does obviously dirty up your diet, but focus here on look too much into what I'm saying relative to the fries itself. Yes, have, but don't overdo. So I suggest, if you are going to indulge, have approximately one of each, one half moon, one samosa, one pie, and that's it. So three total, as to not completely disrupt what you're trying to achieve in your calorie intake and macro makeup. Then, and which are the macro makeup I'll discuss at the end of this video. Then, thirdly, you'll then break and go for Tarawih Salah, and you'll have an opportunity then to digest this food that you've just taken in. Obviously, meanwhile, taking in more water to one facilitate some form of digestion. No, it does not contain the enzymes necessary, but it facilitates not digestion, but the movement thereof, and also the formulation of a ideal breakdown of the food. Then next, you get back then from Tarawih, you've had an opportunity for this food, your meal one, to digest, and now you, let's say, hungry again. Meal two then takes place in the exact same format as meal one. What does it comprise of? Once again, 100 grams of basmati, 1 cup of veggies, and 150 grams of protein. Now you can change it up if your budget allows, or if not relative to the budget, specific to your taste, texture, etc. If you enjoy the same thing, or you don't mind the same thing over and over, that is perfectly fine. You won't have a problem then with this diet, and it fits in basically towards consuming your 3000 to 3500 calories. So this approach would be ideal. Now by this point you would have had approximately 3000 calories, and you're well on your way to almost finishing the day with an ideal diet. At the end of the day, you might just before sleeping, you once again you encouraged to top off the day with a whey protein. Or like I said in the beginning as well, if you have access to casein, which is much more expensive for that matter, then consume this, because it is going to contribute towards your overall protein intake for the day. Now, to conclude, this does not speak to every single person's goal, but for the majority of those who I have spoken to, this does apply, and you will definitely see major benefit through approaching your diet and calorie and macro build up in this method, and therefore I would advise to follow this protocol. However, if you have a specific question other than what I've already specified, then get hold of me and I'll be able to attempt to assist where I can. I'm not promising anything relative to time, etc., but this would be the platform to then obviously attempt this. As I've said earlier, your energy stores are going to be depleted greatly. So what's going to happen is that initially your quick release energy is going to be depleted almost immediately within the first hour or two of the day. Then second to that, what's going to happen is that your body is going to start, even via minor or minimal exercise or activity, your body is going to start depleting its both let's start first with your liver glycogen stores, as well as then your muscle glycogen stores, which is not ideal, because the last thing we want is for the body to start consuming the protein stores in the form of muscle as energy. So the reason why I mention this is that you will find that if looking at the macros in this diet, the macros are largely leaning towards a high carbohydrate intake. So yes, you will have purists looking at high fat, high protein, low carb intake. Listen, I'm not speaking to those, and yes, there is a place and a application therefore, but this specific diet is going to apply to those who are high or who are still going to be training in the month of Ramadan. So just before, like I said in my previous post, just before starting commencement of fast, or just after, or for that matter, when just before breaking fast or just after breaking fast, either way, you're going to require enough energy stores, and we do not want to start using the muscle itself as an energy store, and therefore we're replenishing by virtue of reloading or recarbing for that matter. So now I've spoken about glycogen in the form of energy. I've spoken about the macros as opposed to your normal 40-40-20 split. You're looking more at a 50-30-20 split, with 50 carbs, 50% carbs, 30% protein, and 20% fat. Yes, it is not the most clean in the traditional sense, but it will largely contribute towards your goal. Now, speaking quickly with regards to your training, I will be posting a video in the next couple of days relative to training. I will go through the training itself. Now, it might not be tomorrow, which is probably the day before fasting, but even so, I will be posting it hopefully during the course of this week, and I will be taking you through an entire 20-minute training session, as I've previously advised, which would be sufficient if incorporating all the principles in the form of resistance loading, as well as moderate or mild to moderate intensity, thus not depleting very quickly the energy stores, as well as loading enough to either maintain or overload in terms of resistance in order to build. And then last but not least, remember your IGF factors in order to maintain your growth hormone levels within the body, thus optimizing, or rather, yes, thus optimizing the potential to maintain your muscle mass, or for that matter, in the form of overload and optimal growth hormone levels to actually build. I hope this helped greatly. I know there's a lot of jargon thrown around, but don't worry too much. Apply these principles as far as what you can, and I'd love to hear your feedback relative to this. If we don't speak soon, or if we're not in contact at all, Ramadan Mubarak. I hope you guys have a lovely Ramadan. And also for those non-Muslims who are going to partake in some form of intermittent fasting, please share your experience and results, because we'd love to hear from you guys as well. Till we speak again, enjoy, peace.